Ramon, I think this is the place. There's no name, but the sign matches the logo on the business card I found on Edgar's body. And
Vermina Avenue.
Sorry, could you repeat that? Right. Yeah. Some kind of tramp was standing on the sidewalk outside the building in a suit, advertising milk. No brand, just milk. A pool of the stuff had collected around his feet somehow as well. I tried not to make eye contact. There's a little metal plaque on this building with something printed on it. This building marks the original headquarters of the now-defunct Furrington Candy Corporation. Gutted decades ago during the Great Freak Candy Floss Fire, the exterior was restored and is now a protected historical site. Tastes so informative. Not really. It actually tastes like uncleaned brass. Yuckers. The MMF Postal Service put signs up, begging people not to steal mail. So people stole the signs instead. I wonder if they considered that a net win. It's a crime to open someone else's mailbox without good reason. Like, if I heard a tiny cat trapped inside, I could open it to free him, but only then. It's been out in the weather for years. There's bird droppings on it, and the paint is peeling. In summary, I don't want to. What is your story, you weird, crazy cat? Although, I could ask that about half the cats in this city. Excuse me, is this the establishment?
Jiminy Halibut! Leviathan Puddle Hopper!
I'm sorry, good sir, I don't understand what you're saying.
Xanthum Papadum Trickle Flower!
Okay, I'm just gonna go.
Goodbye, Bubbles!
Wait, did you just say goodbye? You understood me!
Whispering slurp.
Or not, okay. Your, milk is leaking out. Not sure if you're, aware of that.
Lop, lap, lop, lap.
Ooh, is your suit full of milk? Doesn't that make it all warm and nasty?
Kretwurst?
I'm sorry, sir. I just don't understand you. Good luck with the whole milk thing, though. I'm probably going to regret this, but can I lick you?
Free from me, moo!
Definitely not, you say. Well, I tried. Y'all saw me. A fancy door with fancy carvings made of fancy wood. This seems like a classy place. Ooh, imported Hunwan hardwood for sure. Okay, now I am impressed. That's expensive.
Go away, Dunk. Oh, who are you?
My name's Cuddles Nutterbutter. I'm sorry to disturb you, but I'm looking for the establishment.
Why do you...
Garky Ventacular!
Shut up, Duncan! As I was saying, what are you...
Ellie! Oh, Desdimble!
I'm looking into a murder. The victim had your card on him, and...
Ducky quack, hot pot.
Your card on him and...
Patty, lappy, flappy, jab, jab.
Okay, well, what's your problem, bub? Can't you see I'm trying to have a conversation with,
Celestine, and don't bother trying to reason with him. Derpy Duncan never listens. Is this about Edgar Montague?
You knew him?
I was aware of him. I heard he turned up dead.
Oops-a-daisy! Fluttering Quaver Restrooms! Ugh.
Listen, can you let me in? I have more questions, and this Duncan fellow is really annoying.
No. I won't be opening this door for you or anyone else. Not with Duncan there. If I open it more than a crack when he's around, he rushes inside and it takes hours to get rid of him. He waddles around, talking nonsense and splashing milk over everything, and I have to get out the good chasing stick to go after him. It's dreadful. And to add insult to leaky injury, all I smell for days after is curdled milk.
Ugh.
No, come back when he's not around. Good night.
Wait, this is important.
More important than spending a weekend mopping up milk stains? More important than the very expensive dinner reservation I missed at the Gourmand's gazebo? Oh, I was so looking forward to it. Not tonight, apparently. Trapped here by an insane, milk-swilling feline instead.
Today has been tiresome and has left me entirely disinterested in indulging another strange cat, especially one who dresses like you. The tie isn't working, by the way.
Walk, 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 jabroni. Walk, 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 walk.
Please, there's more at stake than you realize. Bartholomew Montemieu is looking for vengeance, and if I don't find out what he wants to know, there was talk of declawing machines.
Oh, Bartholomew has lit a fire under your tail, No wonder you look like you've got a sniper trained on you. The thing is, I know Bartholomew. We're, terrific buddies, I believe is the term. He's too smart to do anything to make me upset at him, so I think this is a Cuddles problem and not a Celestine problem.
Can't you call the police to get rid of Duncan here?
The police, ever champions of the city's downtrodden, no longer respond when I report the mad, milk-drenched cat stalking my sidewalk. Apparently, it is not urgent.
Hey, there's a lot of stuff worse than Duncan happening in the city all the time, you know? Like murder. Speaking of which, can I just ask you?
You may not. I am disinclined to put up with smart-mouthed cats or their problems right now. Doubly so, ones that have clearly never eaten at the Gourmand's gazebo if they think murder is worse than missing a reservation.
Ugh. I might have a Cuddles problem, but you've definitely got a Duncan problem. Am I right?
Are you this quick on the uptake with all facts presented to you on a platter?
Ha ha! So, what if I get rid of Duncan for you?
Xylophone canola fiesta?
Oh, you think it's that easy? I've tried everything. Sprays, signs, alarms, threats. He's immune to them all. But you're welcome to waste your time trying.
Just don't hurt him. Then the police will get involved, and I will seal this portal forever for any egregiously dressed feline seeking entry.
What is that, me?
Quick as a whip.
All right. Let me see if I can resolve your Duncan situation. It's a crime to open someone else's mailbox without good reason. Like, if I heard a tiny cat trapped inside, I could open it to free him, but only then. All right. Let me see if I can resolve your Duncan. Hey, Duncan. Get. Go on. Shoo. Please.
Preppy giant.
No, really. See, there's a giant a cookie suit coming this way. No, if you don't leave, he'll dip in you and soak up all your milk. Oh. The cat said nothing for once, but looked at me with a flat expression. Okay. Judged by a crazy cat in a milk suit. I tried. What are you even doing here? This area's not even busy. Who are you selling to? The cat turned to look up at the building sign, then back at me.
Lappity jerk! Don't come back!
I don't know what that means. Do you want to eat the sign? Hug it? You want to kidnap it to make some sort of monstrous sign bride?
Catootie.
I'll kid your tootie. Hey, Duncan. Oh, hey, Duncan. Is that an ice cream van I hear? Oh, why not run down the road and check? And if it isn't, no need to come back.
Rash, false crew.
Duncan, I've just gotten word that Porky Pete's has a special on for all dairy sales cats. Buy one, get 28 free. Better go before they're sold out.
Porkly, hust.
Not interested, huh? Oh no, Duncan, the milk thieves are coming. You save your milky goodness and run away, flee.
Dopper's majingy.
Okay, this isn't going anywhere. I'm sorry, sir. I just don't understand you. Good luck with the whole milk thing, though. Hello? Are you still there?
No. I've escaped via a secret tunnel that I failed to use until now for no good reason. What do you want?
I'm not getting anywhere with Duncan. Sometimes it seems like he understands me, but he never says anything sensible.
Cross-latched! Whisper hump!
Yes, I know. If it was as straightforward as just asking, don't you think I'd have gotten rid of him by now?
Well, can I just ask you some questions about Edgar through the door?
Stand here and be interrogated through a door? Like a farmer? Absolutely not! Here at the establishment, our standards are inviolable.
You care a lot about your image, huh? I bet you'd just loathe it if something were to happen to it.
What are you saying?
I think I'll put an advert in the newspaper. Yeah, more people need to know about your snooty little club, definitely. But the establishment, it's such a generic name. I think what people really want to visit is Celestine's fun farm.
You wouldn't dare.
Bring the whole family, especially your dirty children. Touch everything. Free face painting.
No, enough. Fine, Nutter Butter. We ordered a book to try to communicate with Duncan. Maybe it's arrived.
There! See? That wasn't so hard.
I would not crow just yet, Nutter Butter. I ordered it with extra secure packaging.
What did you say about a book?
We ordered a book to try to communicate with Duncan. A book is a collection of words that...
All right, Captain Condescension, I get it. All right, let me see if I can resolve your Duncan situation. Oh, packaged with ultra-dense paper for your convenience. Oh, yes. You're all mine, little package. Oh, you're mine now, little package. You know, Ramon, it's the small things that make me love my job. That's crazy talk. Understanding babies, politicians, and very confused people. Should probably try reading it instead of licking it. See if this works.
Okey-dokey. Okey-dokey. Voila.
What?
That didn't mean anything to him. Let's see if this works.
Kiptoki. Voila.
Chumga! Mackety jumpstop Vimina!
those red birds are in here. Okay, that translates to milk thirsty kitty. What?
Mackety jumpstop Vimina! Mackety jumpstop Vimina!
Oh, so you want to sell milk to the cats inside because you think that's a thirsty cat on the sign? I'm sorry to tell you, Duncan, but that's not thirst. I don't know, it's entitlement or money or something.
Perspex holiday!
Hello? Are you still there? I found a package in your postbox.
Yes, I know. I could hear you fumbling around outside like a drunken moose. Don't damage the book. I want it back in pristine condition.
I know why Duncan wants to enter.
So do I. He's crazy.
Yes, maybe a little, but that's not why. It's your sign. He thinks it means there are thirsty cats inside and he wants to sell them milk.
Milk? As in, from... carton? Preposterous! Our patrons don't drink anything that takes fewer than 10 years to mature in oak barrels.
But he doesn't know that. I think if you turn the sign off, you'll lose interest and just wander away.
Cuckoo Walkerhauser!
I refuse!
But I just told you how to get rid of him.
That sign has not once been turned off since we first opened our doors. It is a symbol to our patrons and this entire agitated city of our unshakable reliability. Find another way.
If you turn your sign off, Duncan will leave.
The establishment will not go dark for a mangy cat in a leaking milk suit. If that's what it takes, I will simply wait him out, even if it takes all night.
If you turn your sign off...
The establishment will not go dark for a mangy cat in a leaking milk suit. If that's what it takes, I will simply wait him out, even if it takes all night.
All right. Let me see if I can resolve your Duncan situation. I think you need proper training or a certificate or something to use one of these. Oh, man, I've got to show this to Tabby. The hook whip. Wait, no. The whip hook. I'd better get this patented immediately. This changes everything. Everything that can be hooked. Ramon, make a note. Well, you don't have hands. Okay, it's fine. I won't forget. Whip hook, whip. I'm gonna be rich! Whip hook. The handy tool with 100 handy uses. Oh, yeah, the jingle just wrote itself, baby. invent. Well, there's steam leaking out from this window. Powerfully built cat, all but covered in tattoos, sat in a heated pool of water. His gigantic arms rested leisurely on the sides, and his feet occasionally broke the surface to splash the water. He looked scary, but his face was open and welcoming. I hoped that reflected how he'd react to my sudden appearance above him.
Psst. Hey.
Huh? Who said that?
Up here.
What the? Who are you? What are you doing up there?
I'm the window inspector. I'm inspecting your windows. Yes, this sure is a window here. This looks nice. Very see-through.
The window inspector? Why, big blue one-armed Clive, you've really changed.
You've called my bluff. Okay, well, I don't know why I said I was from the window inspector. I'm not. My name's Cuddles, and I'm a PI.
Well, that's not the front door, friend. Doors have handles, and are on the ground floor.
Right, sorry. Hello again, it's me, Cuddles.
Hello, friend. Everything looking good from up there?
Yeah, windows. These are good windows.
They got a good drip shield, and they got lots of caulking.
Glad to hear it.
Hey, the doorman doesn't want me to come into the building.
Celestine? He's not the doorman, friend. He's the owner.
Well, whatever. He's so annoying. I'm just trying to do my job, and he stands there with his fat feet and his stupid hat.
Oh, he doesn't wear hats, and his feet are quite petite. And as for his attitude, is Duncan still out there? Because that would be why.
Yes! Do you know how to get rid of him?
Well, the only way I know of, friend, is waiting until he leaves.
I guess I'm off. This will hide it, and what Celestine doesn't know won't hurt his snooty, upturned nose. Oh, well, there we go. All sorted. Now, Duncan, is that smoke? Oh, yikes! Fire! Oh, I can't whistle. Nothing to see here. Is normal. Signs, they go on fire all the time. It's a good thing, if anything. Now they have lots of spare fire. Yeah, they can put some all over to spruce up the place. Do I really want to try to... No, Cuddles, just calm down, Cuddles. You're being hysterical. There are no thirsty kitties inside. See? The sign is on fire. Off. I mean off. The sign is off.
Blowpack nasal.
I don't have time to go through the whole book again, so, Hoopy, drop saggles. Moopy. Does that mean anything?
Snaggly sniffle.
Snaggly sniffle. No.
Sniffle.
Ramon, what do you think has to happen to a cat for them to end up like that? I hope he's got someone to look out for him.
Thank you.
Hello? Are you still there? Okay. Duncan is gone. Can I please come in now?
How on earth did you manage that? Did you turn off the sign? I told you we don't turn off the sign.
No, the sign is still on, technically. I guess I'm simply charming enough to persuade him to leave.
Why do I smell smoke?
Do you? Weird. Someone must be having a barbecue. Anyway, Duncan's gone. The sign is 100% still on. So let's talk about Edgar.
Very well, you tiresome cat. You may enter.
I had thought Tybalt just about the fanciest cat I'd ever seen, but I had to revise that judgment after seeing Celestine. This cat had a waistcoat and a pocket watch. I could only hope that whatever fancy accent he doubtless spoke would be intelligible to peasants like me.
Wowee, fancy place you got here.
Yes, I imagine this is quite a fresh experience for you, being surrounded by such excellence.
Actually, I've been in the VIP area at Porky Beach quite a few times, so I know a thing or two about class. You should consider putting up a painting of a dancing bear. Adds a ton of class.
I will take that under advisement. Conscience demands that I thank you for getting rid of Duncan.
Sure. I scratch your back, you scratch mine, right? Yeah.
Yeah, back-scratching claws are available on request, but you will be required to scratch your own back with it. And I'll take my book back now, if you don't mind. If I find so much as a single claw scratch on it, well, you can expect a bill.
So, what's all this for?
The cat blinked at me so fast, I thought his glasses might slip off his nose.
What is it for?
Well, with all the pools of water and the steam in the air, I'm guessing laundromat.
No, your lack of culture is astounding. This is a bathhouse.
Oh, I didn't know we had any of those in this city. How exotic. So cats come here to sit in water voluntarily.
Well, unlike you, clearly, not all cats wish to lick themselves for hours a day. Some find it very relaxing to unwind in a warm bath. We also act as a neutral location for certain types to meet.
Certain type? Like the Montagues you're on such good terms with?
And others. The establishment is neutral ground. Here, we are all merely cats. Even the criminals that pervade our city. Outside allegiances must be left at the door, along with any weapons. Claws are sheathed, and the sharpest things thrown are words. The crime families have been meeting here, peacefully, for years, to discuss points of shared interest.
And the police force doesn't know? The vast eye-roll motion turned the cat's eyes white for a moment.
Of course they know. They even visit now and then. Perhaps they think to get an idea of what's going on with all their favorite families. I like to think of it as a police cat's soap opera, but there are no criminals inside our walls, just cats. Relaxing.
Do you know anything about Duncan's history? He's clearly not all there.
Well, I know nothing about where he came from. He started appearing a year or two ago, but he was at least somewhat lucid then. I could shoo him away with a loud yell. He's become entirely senseless since then. Nothing penetrates his skull anymore. He just stands around, blabbering nonsense.
Well, he's selling milk for someone. Perhaps if we can find out.
I'm sorry. Did something I say give you the impression that I am up for joining an impromptu ragtag band of plucky true crime fans to solve low-effort mysteries in and around the city, armed with a spiral notebook and no prior law enforcement experience? No, there is no we. There is only Cuddles.
And Ramon. I found your card on Edgar's body. That implies to me that he was planning to pay you a visit, or already had.
Yes, he was here. Sauntered in last night, cocky as a prince. A first-time visit for him, but of course I knew who he was. I made one of our private rooms available to him. He was surprisingly polite, up until he dashed out with no warning a short while later and never returned.
He was here yesterday. That must have only been hours before he died. What did he do? Did he speak to anyone? Did he say anything? I'll need immediate access to the room he used. The cat clasped a hand to his chest as if I'd asked him for his firstborn.
Certainly not.
Celestine, this is important. A cat is dead.
And I imagine he'll remain that way indefinitely. Nutterbutter, you are here as a guest, solely at my discretion. If you annoy me, I will toss you out of here faster than you can say, do you serve a continental breakfast, which we do not.
I just want answers, that's all.
Be that as it may, the room in question is being used by someone already, an actual member. He's had a difficult day, and I won't have you disturbing him.
Celestine, I promise I will do my best to be quiet and not annoy you or anyone else. Just tell me, did Edgar meet with anyone? Keep their identity a secret if you must, but did he?
No. He arrived alone and left alone a short while later in a rush, as I said. Perhaps he forgot something.
In a rush? Might he have left any items behind?
If he did, he would have placed them in his personal locker, but the locks to those are given directly to new members, and each is unique. Even I cannot unlock them.
I'll need a list of the people who were here last night, please.
Certainly. Shall I scent the list with rose water for you? Perhaps add some glitter?
Okay.
That was sarcasm. I am not going to divulge any information about our clients, Nutterbutter. Discretion is our motto.
Really? It's not on your business card or your sign.
Thus proving just how discreet we are.
I am investigating a murder on the authority of the chief of police. Let me through, please.
Very impressive credentials. Oh, capital letters and all, I don't doubt. Unfortunately for you, the only sort of credential I respect is the one I grant, and the one that you, as a guest, do not possess.
Okay, that's all for now. Never! A hard pumice scrub and deep flannel pat-down was good enough for my parents, and it's good enough for me! At least the water's clean. For now.
Mr. Nutterbutter, you are not a member here and thus do not have freedom of movement. You may speak to me or wander the atrium listlessly like a sad paper bag atop a gentle breeze, but that is all.
I mean, I know it's just a mural, but it'd still feel weird licking a lady on a wall. Oh, this is supposed to be Nukina, the patron cat of scoliosis. Odd place to see a picture of her.
Halt! Non-members are not permitted to wander about freely. This is not an amusement park for you to sample at your leisure.
The owner let me into the club, at last.
I'm glad to hear that, friend.
But now he won't let me go investigate the rooms without being a member. Can you help me out, since you're in the private area? I think if you lift your arms, I can balance my feet on your paws and you could lower me down.
Oh dear. Is the owner being brusque?
He is. Do you know him well? Is he always like this?
Sometimes.
It's so annoying. He stands there, all tall and fancy with his spectacles, checking his pocket watch far more frequently than anyone needs to. And all he says when you explain your problem is how you're not a full member, so he doesn't care. Ugh.
Oh, he's not so bad. I'm probably biased after being married to him for 15 years.
So it's quite high up here, and I think the distance may have caused you to mishear some of the things I said.
Relax, friend. Celestine's a wonderful cat, but he's had a difficult day. Our assistant, Edna, didn't show up for work, so we had to do twice the usual work. On top of that, we've been dieting all week. Oh, our reward was supposed to be a delicious dinner tonight, but Duncan showed up and wrecked that plan. So we're both a little tetchy. I'm sure if you come back when he's had time to rest and recover, you two will get along like a building on fire.
I'm sorry, but I can't wait. Edgar Montemieux was here hours before he died, and I need to know why.
The Montemieux kid? Yeah, I heard about that. No wonder there was a buzz of activity here today. And you're the unlucky guy that got the case,
Can I ask you about him?
I'm not in the mood to field murder questions through a window, friend.
Could you speak to Celestine for me? It really is important that I investigate the areas Edgar was in.
I'm with Celestine on this one, friend. A dead mobster doesn't bother me. There's plenty more where he came from.
Listen, Bartholomew is not in a good headspace about all this. If I don't find out what happened, he's gonna start doing his own digging. Violently. And if he does, a place like this, that depends on the illusion of civility from very uncivil cats, it won't last long. There was a languid splashing sound as a heavy body shifted about in the tub below.
Interesting point of view. Might happen. Might not.
But it might.
True.
The splashing continued for a moment. So...
I'm sorry, friend, but no. I sympathize with your goals, I really do. But the establishment's rules are clear, and I won't break them for no reason. If you'd caught me on a day I wasn't dieting, maybe I'd feel more generous. But, alas...
Please help me get into the other rooms. I have to find out what Edgar was doing here.
Sorry, friend. My grumbling stomach has left me grumpy and disinterested.
I guess I'm off. I happen to be in possession of a basket full of really nice food. I think it's more than enough to make up for the dinner you missed and your diet.
Oh. That smell is... But I can't grant you membership just for some food, no matter how delicious it...
There's an entire jar of roast puffin wings.
Did you say roast puffin wings? Oh, the Tastemaster ones? Ooh.
The very same, with cherry sauce and melted cheese on top.
Oh, All right. Lower the basket and you can have my membership card. But don't tell Celestine that I broke my diet.
He even makes you have a membership card?
He's a stickler for the rules. I don't mind. It makes him happy, but never mind that now. Just lower the food.
A membership card for the establishment. Why, yes, I am a member of the establishment. Meow Meow Furrington's foremost secretive club place. That's... Oh, wow, lemongrass. It's infused with taste. They did it. The Mad Cats actually did it. think I've exhausted the tasting opportunities that I care about on this. This should slither down into the private spa room like a wet leather snake. Ugh. Ah, why did I say that? I found my membership card.
Where did you get that? Now, I remember every single person I've issued one of those cards to, Nutter Butter, and you're definitely not one of them.
Well, I believe the rule is you can only get access with a membership card. And here's my card. See? It says so, right there. Member.
I also noticed that it says Humboldt.
Yeah, that's my middle name. Cuddles Humboldt Nutterbutter, the third Esquire. After all, you never said it had to be my card.
You are technically correct.
The best sort of correct.
Fine. You may have access to the member areas, but only for tonight. You may not move any items between my rooms, and you may only take what is on your person into the changing rooms. You must wear the correct dress code at all times. You may use locker number 9 for your effects.
The cat smirked triumphantly.
Locker 9 is the one closest to the urinals.
Oh, that's just unnecessary.
Enjoy your visit, Nutterbutter. One more thing. I won't have it said that the establishment treats any member, even a temporary one, poorly. Please, take this gift bag. Ugh, I recommend making generous use of its contents. Ugh, soon.
Oh, free goodies! Let's see. Some scented oil. All right. Neat. I'll keep that. And wait, is that all? Nothing else? Why was this in a bag by itself? How bored does a cat have to be for them to decide that this is how they'll start spending their casual time? Absolutely clean. Good to know they care about hygiene. Wouldn't want any blood stains sticking around, I'm sure. I can pack my things in there to keep them safe while I look around. Better pack all my inventory items in here. I feel ridiculous. Licky licky, screeny weeny, with the boring whirling, tasty wasty. It's a dressing screen for cats who are shy, I guess. Guess who won't be needing that, Ramon? It's me. I'm here, in person. Hello!
How's your window, sir?
Remember that?
Hello, friend.
I couldn't help but notice your tattoos. Do they mean something?
These? Oh, yes. These are my graduation tattoos.
Oh, wow. You got all that to celebrate graduation?
Not to celebrate, no. As proof of it, I studied overseas for many years, training to be a professional basher. When you graduate, instead of a certificate, you receive these tattoos. It lets others know what you can do and to leave you alone.
That's really interesting. A basher? I met a crusher the other day, but he wore a suit, so I couldn't see his arms. Wonder if he also has tattoos.
Do you mean Tin Vankelyanta? He is a good crusher, but crushing is the path for those without the strength of will to be bashers. True, bashing comes from a place of control and understanding. When you bash, you do not simply hit something. You let it hit you back. You feel it in your soul. Otherwise, you're no better than a smoosher.
The community of melee combatants sounds far more complex than I ever imagined.
Just don't listen to the pro-smooshing propaganda. Smooshers are charlatans. They couldn't smoosh a paper bag.
Thanks for lending me your membership card, but it seems it was for nothing. Edgar's locker is locked, and without the key, not even Celestine can open it, apparently. Is he lying about that?
No, he's right. Each member is issued a unique lock and key that is never duplicated.
He had no key on his body, though, so either someone took it or he didn't have it on him at the time. Do your clients ever leave their keys here?
I'm not going to divulge all of our secrets just because you fed me, friend. Discretion is our motto.
Well, if I can't figure out what's in there, your motto might have to change to, "We'll beat cats up for food," because your clients will be too busy gunning one another down in the streets to have time to relax here.
Yes, you mentioned that possibility earlier. I'm curious, friend. Why so much effort for this kid? Did you know him?
I had no idea he existed before the chief pulled me into this case. But the police won't touch things because of who he was, so I feel that I have to.
Why? He was just another criminal who paid for his mistakes, was he not?
Maybe I'll know for sure when I've unraveled this whole thing. For now, my active investigation is keeping Bartholomew from hunting down anyone he feels is responsible. The city has enough problems. We need to put in the work if we want it to get better. Nobody will do it for us.
Interesting. He said a similar thing.
Who?
Edgar. Last night.
You spoke to him when he was here? What did he say? Please, I need to know.
Not much. He was in a rush to leave, which I thought was rude since he'd only just arrived. He said he'd lost something and he had to go fetch it. But he would be back. But he asked me to keep something for him.
Oh, please say it was his
key. His key, yes. And that was strange, because if he was just going to fetch something, he should have just taken it with him. But there was something in his expression, so I pressed him a little. He looked really worried, like he was being hunted. But all he told me was that he was just trying to change things in the city, and that nobody else could do it, only him. He forced his key on me and said it was just in case, and left, and never came back.
Humboldt, I need you to give me that key. I have to know what Edgar put in his locker.
Oh, Celestine won't like it if I...
Celestine doesn't like anything except maintaining the status quo with all his annoying rules. I'm sorry, I know he's your husband, but he doesn't care what happened to Edgar. But you do, Humboldt. Whatever Edgar was trying to do, he seemed to know it had put him in danger, and he was clearly right. He left that key with you to keep something safe. Whatever it is, I'll bet it's why he was killed. And that means I need to get my paws on it to figure out how to solve this case.
I can't just give it to you, friend. We have rules.
A trade, then. Like before, I bring you something, and hey, maybe when I get back, I just happen to find the key that Edgar, dropped. Edgar thought he was the only one who could do whatever he was going to do. Well, he's gone. So if anyone else has a chance of doing it, it's me. but only with that key.
Well, I do feel quite full after that meal, and this tub is warm. Perhaps if I had something to make me even more relaxed, I might doze off and drop anything I'm holding.
Oh, wink, wink.
And if someone were to pick up whatever I dropped...
Wink, wink.
Repeatedly saying wink, wink out loud is rather ruining the effect, friend. Regardless, you're not going to be able to just walk out with it. There are metal detectors on all the doors for security.
I guess I'm off. That feels much better. Briefcase time again.